Hey traveler, there's few things as exciting as finding an incredibly cheap flight deal. But instead of spending our hard-earned cash, let's utilize credit card travel rewards to book it for free. Let me walk you through my five favorite points and miles programs for booking cheap cash flights. First up is the Chase Ultimate Rewards program. So now with Chase, there's two important cards you need to know about, the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Chase Sapphire Reserve. Both cards earn Ultimate Rewards points, but when you go to redeem those points, they redeem at different amounts. So now with the Preferred card, those Ultimate Rewards points redeem at 1.25 cents towards flight deals. Now with the Reserve card, those points redeem at 1.5 cents. So you can see with the Reserve, you get a little bit more bang for your buck. There's also some other very important differences as far as travel credits, lounge access, and most importantly, the annual fee. So each card is gonna fit different spending patterns, and there's a great head-to-head comparison in the links below. Next up is American Express's Membership Rewards Program. Now, Amex has a wide array of different cards where you can earn membership rewards points, but the most important takeaway is generally one membership reward point equals 1 cent. So it's definitely less lucrative than Chase's Ultimate Rewards Program, but there are two notable exceptions, and they all have to do with the American Express Platinum lineup of cards. The first benefit is the IAP program, or the International Airline program. And this is important for people who like to book premium cabin travel. So premium economy, business class, first class, through the IAP program, you can save up to $600 off of each flight. So if you take $600 off the price of a flight, obviously that requires less points or membership rewards when you ultimately go to book. So this is an easy way to save on premium cabin travel. The next one, and probably my favorite, is related to the American Express Business Platinum card, and that is its 35% rebate. So every single year, you get to choose one airline, and every time you book through the Amex portal with that airline, you get a 35% rebate. So for example, I choose Delta every single year because I live in a Delta hub. So when I go and I book my Delta flights with my membership rewards points, I get 35% back every single time, which is a great benefit, and it puts it on par with the Chase Ultimate Rewards earning lineup of cards. So if you'd like to learn more about the IAP program as well as the 35% rebate, check out the links below. Next up is the Citi Thank You Points program. Now, Citi's program has only one card that you should focus on if you're looking to book flights, and that is the Citi Premier card. So with the Premier card, your points redeem at 1.25 cents per point. So that puts it on par with the Chase Sapphire Preferred card. They're very similar, they have a low annual fee, they have a sizable sign-up bonus, which both of those things make them definitely worth checking out. Next up is Delta's SkyMiles Pay With Miles program. So if you have one of the co-branded credit cards from American Express and Delta, so like the Amex Delta Gold, Platinum, or Reserve card, you have access to the Pay With Miles program. So essentially, when you go to delta.com, you're searching for flights. When you go to pay, you can choose the drop-down menu and you can pay with SkyMiles, or you can pay some cash, some SkyMiles, you can kind of mix and match. So one of the great things for Delta elites that are working towards Delta Medallion status is Pay With Miles tickets still earn MQMs or Medallion Qualifying Miles towards Delta status. So this is super cool in comparison to an award ticket which earns no MQMs. And it's definitely why this is a very popular feature for Delta elites. Last but not least is the Capital One Venture Miles program. And the one card that we're big fans of is the Capital One Venture card. Super easy to use, especially for beginners, but I'd recommend really anybody signing up for it. The fact that it has no annual fee the first year, great sign-up bonus. You get free TSA pre-check or global entry. Again, no annual fee the first year. And the points are so simple. Each Venture Mile is worth 1 cent. Every dollar that you spend on the card, though, does earn 2 Venture Miles, so you do get that nice multiplier. And the fact that when you actually go to use these miles, you don't have to go through a portal, you don't have to do anything. You just put the charge, whether it's a flight, an Airbnb, a train, whatever travel-related charge you have, you just take those Venture Miles and use the purchase eraser, and you literally wipe it off of your credit card statement. It doesn't get any easier than that, and that's why we always recommend it as a great beginner card. We've got a bunch of links for the Venture card below. Check it out. Now that you know how to book flights with credit card travel rewards, head over to thriftytraveler.com, where we feature US domestic flight deals every single day. And if you're looking for international flight deals, check out Thrifty Traveler Premium, where we find international deals departing from 135 different US and Canadian departure cities. Check it out at thriftytraveler.com/premium. Cheers to cheap flights. So if you've liked this video, definitely give us a thumbs up below and subscribe to the Thrifty Traveler channel.